Bay at 5:30. Andy?
Rick, Victoria Roach tells us her ordeal here at Metro Corrections was not only humiliating, she believes it cost her her job.
They endangered me. I mean, anything could have happened to me. That was scary.
A month later, Victoria Roach is still upset about her arrest in June and incarceration at Metro Corrections. When police officers brought her to jail, corrections officers questioned her sexual identity.
They asked me, was I born male or female? I told them I was a female. And they still took me and just locked me up in isolation with the men.
Colonel Joe Payne of Corrections says procedure was followed properly. When officers can't determine the sex of a person during the initial processing, a medical person or nurse is brought in to determine whether a male or female corrections officer should search the person.
Yeah, she said she's female. Medical said to treat this person as a male. So therefore, we put that person in a single cell to not to have any conflicts with other inmates.
But Victoria Roach showed us documented proof she's a woman. Her birth certificate, her marriage license, even the birth certificates of three of her five children.
If they could bring that documentation to the jail, then that way we could treat, I guess, her as a female from now on.
The ordeal has not only angered Roach, it's angered her mother.
I think that is wrong. And because she's a full woman, she's not no man.
Victoria Roach also believes she never should have been arrested in the first place. She says Louisville police arrested her at gunpoint for being in her own vehicle they said was stolen. She says the former owner of the vehicle who had it repossessed listed it as stolen. Court records indicate the case against her was dropped and she was released from corrections. But Roach says the flap over her jail stay and need to go to court also cost her her job.
I want to make sure that doesn't happen to anybody else. You know, because, I mean, what's going to happen to the next person?
And Roach says she's in the process of filing a lawsuit. She also tells us she has filed a discrimination complaint against her former employer, PSC Office Supplies. A spokeswoman for that company declined comment. Reporting live outside Metro Corrections downtown, I'm Andy Alcock.
Was a male.
Rick, from what we understand, there was not any type of strip search. We believe, from what Joe Payne tells us, that the corrections officer simply talked to her, or this medical person, and the determination was made at that point.